So right after I played the game that we defeated the Ottawa Senators 5-2 in, I tried to play this Florida Panthers game, and it was very close, very low scoring. And unfortunately, the PS3, like, it just crashed in the middle of the gameplay in the third period. So I will tell you this, Mike Ribeiro did score a goal in the gameplay, and the recording, the video recording saved, but the PS3 just cut off in the third period, just out of nowhere, just shut down. So Ribeiro has a goal taken off the board. Somebody else scored in that game, I think, as well. I thought we had a second goal. I don't know how this is all going to be edited and pieced together in the future, because this will be edited several months down the line from when it's being recorded here over Christmas holiday. But I think we did make changes to the lines. I don't know if those are still here. Are they still here? Perreault and Johansson are in the lineup. So those changes are still there. And Ovechkin is on the point on the power play. Actually, that needs to be changed. From the gameplay that I did that you're not going to see, I actually find that Ovechkin on the left wing actually works better for those power play one-timers. Back home in the nation's capital for what I believe is a extended stay at home. We have a homestand coming up, I do think so, on the calendar. No team so far in the two games we played, this is just the third game of the year, but no team so far has been able to hold off this offensive attack that is the Washington Capitals. And that is what's surprising, is that Ovechkin is not even the one that's humming along right now. It's actually Mike Ribeiro that is humming along. I got to change the forecheck strategies. Let me get that done before we jump into this. So again, I already said this, but I've tried to play this game out earlier last evening, the day before recording this, and the game, the console itself, that is, just decided to just throw a rage quit on me. And threw me for a loop. Now, it wasn't a very great game. Oh, yeah. Hold on. Oh, we tried to toe drag it through Theodore. And so, much like the gameplay from last night, we have breakaways going on early on in this one. But yeah, the console just quit on me. And it was a tight game, but we were not playing our best, is what I was going to say before Ovechkin's breakaway we had already in the beginning of this game. And Mike Ribeiro scored a goal in that game on a one-time feed from the grade 8, Alex Ovechkin. Those two are going to be quite the connection. But again, because that's not saved, the actual recording of the gameplay saved, but since we didn't finish the game, it doesn't really matter. And so since it doesn't matter, Ribeiro doesn't have that fourth goal in the season. But he's got three goals. Oh, coming into this one in three games, we're going to have to just send it back in. We're still offside. And it's played by Theodore behind his net, left there for Jovanovski. Good forechecking pressure. Again, in the game against Florida we played through last night, in the attempt I did last night, we didn't exactly play particularly poor, but we were trailing in the third period 2-1. I think we went in 2-1, or maybe it was, I don't remember the exact score, but we weren't doing as much damage offensively as we have done through the early part of the season. Get up there and cover that. We will cover the point. I didn't mean get up there and cover it. Get up there and block the shot. But we're forcing Braden Holtby to go to work pretty early. As usual, we like to make the Holtbeast work for it. That's a tough face-off loss. We got to get on that point guy. There we go. Could Ovechkin find himself with two breakaways? Oh, my God. And a save by Theodore on the blocker side. That's a big one. Oh, I thought we were going to punish Versteeg with the hit in the corner from Ovechkin. He has two breakaways in this game and yet not a goal. One goal on the season. It was scored in the last game against the Ottawa Senators. One thing I like about this Washington team, well, aside from that one there, is we know how to break the puck out. We know how to pass the puck around and break the puck out cleanly for the most part. We're going to go behind the net here. If we can kick it along, we finally do, but a very delayed response in game. And a good play to avoid the pressure. And we find Ovi again. Do we think we can deke to the outside? We can. We'll do another one. And Ovechkin sat down. But in that process, he's kept the puck alive for the Capitals. It goes away from Joel Ward. We'll poke at it again. Forecheck is really good on this team as well. This team is just, I don't know, this team is complete dynamite this season. We're going to rim that hard around the boards. Joel Ward is awaiting. Pressure is arriving quickly, so we'll try to bank it off the glass and out. Brooks like in the neutral zone. This team missing Eric Fair. And in Eric Fair's absence, I have decided to make some alterations to the lineup for this particular game. Marcus Johansson and Matthew Perreault get involved in the action for the first time this season. They were healthy scratches coming into this game. I didn't even freaking know they were healthy scratches, to be honest with you. Somehow, I should have known that Marcus Johansson was a Washington Capitol and was an option. That's offside. Leave it alone. It was just there, but he didn't reach out a stick and try to get it. Trying to set Joel Ward up on a breakaway. That's left pretty easily for Holtby to play. And we should just dump this in. We're a good dump and chase team. That's something that is kind of an identity. I don't know if I've already mentioned that in the Senators game because I don't even remember the commentary from last night. But one of the identities that I want this team to play with is dump and chase. With Nashville, we played with an identity of trying to be a good forechecking team. I want a similar idea here with Washington, and that's not based on anything other than I just want to find an identity with this team. And, you know, watch how a coach comes in and takes over a team. Well, he implements a strategy and an identity for the team. And for me, my identity for this team is dump and chase a bit, quite a bit, especially with the bottom six, the bottom six lines. I want to use those two lines to dump the puck in a lot, and I want to go hard in after it. Man, Florida cannot stay, or not stay, but rather bring the puck in cleanly onside. They're struggling. That was something they struggled in with the game that I played, this matchup that I did last night. Again, the one that rage quit on me. I call it a rage quit. It didn't really rage quit, but the one that the PS3 failed on me. God, the helmet sit. Look at the helmet. Helmet went flying more than the puck did. We are having a tough time right now on the break. A big block by Jack Hillen as well. And that's going to hit a skate. It's going to hit Hillen's skate in front. We got Pody and Erat coming down after trying to support the play. We may have just, well, it's not going to be an icing. There's actually going to be a race for it. Weaver is not going to win, but both take a tumble. The puck is sitting there. And it ended up on Gabranson's stick. He's got it back out the center. We have made a bad pass with Pody. That was not intentional. Fleischmann's helmet's gone flying again. Backstrom with an up and over move. Fleischmann keeps it in. And it's Versteeg, I think, below the net. We're going to poke check it away from Chris Versteeg. Hack and whack at it. And just trying to make a breakout play into the skates of Fleischmann. He's kept the puck in for the Panthers. Good pressure. And then they throw it all the way back in the D zone. God, what a shift. Oh, way too much going on for my brain to try to keep up with. Versteeg is hit hard. Good message sent early in the game. He's got to pick the stick right back up. Good play to keep it in. It's escaping the blade of Brooks Like, both the stick and the skate blades. But we've kept it in. Chimera goes down low. Chimmer finds Ward. Back to Like on the other side of the net. Like got it on net, but a save was made. Versteeg sat down in the corner again. And Brooks Like is just avoiding the puck. Is he allergic to the puck? Allergic to rubber. Why not good? If you're trying to prevent pregnancies. although there are alternative methods to that. Anyway, that is a different subject matter altogether. We're going to go out to center, and it misses another stick because we've got some of the most interesting commentary I've done on this series. This is the most sloppy game I have ever freaking seen, Washington. What are we doing? Let's change the defensive pressure. Maybe we need to change the neutral zone pressure as well. Good God. I mean, the puck is fumbling around. I'm going to hammer this along the boards. And Ikuba would keep the puck in. And we still can't get the... We just cannot get the puck to Jay Beagle up there. Schultz. Quickly. Flings it up. And again, the Panthers just doing a job keeping the puck in. Blocked in front. Stick lift. Finds Mueller. Skilly on. Johansson. Protect that wraparound move. God, we got to get the puck out of our own zone. Johansson knows. Yeah, that's why he's in the lineup. He knows the importance of getting the puck out. We still can't get the puck out. My God. Guys, settle it down. Big rebound cleared by Carlson. And it's still held by Florida at center. We can't even get the puck beyond the red line. D to D, reset, reset. My God, boys. Let's go. Reset yourselves. Let's go. This is pissing me off. Brower, a dangle move to the inside, and he gets Superman at the blue line. This is going to be Schultz trying to play it on. Green to retrieve in the corner. D to D here. Schultz trying to break out under all the pressure in the world. This is the worst I've seen this Capitals team look, especially on the breakout. We got to figure out a solution soon. Schultz. And time is running out. We're going to hammer it in from the red line. Reset and figure ourselves out for the rest of this game. My God. I'm sorry, Brayden Holtby. I know the guys in front of him are doing a work tonight. They have blocked so many shots because only six have gotten. If you wouldn't believe it, but only six shots for the Florida Panthers have gotten through on net. Florida proved to be quite the tough task in the game that I did last night as well. So I think we're going to have our hands full with trying to actually beat the Florida Panthers, a Southeast Division opponent, which it actually is the Southeast Division in this game. Our biggest problem right now is the puck is just not leaving the freaking defensive zone, even when we whack it out. Let's get the puck and slow down for a minute, okay? Yeah, settle down. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. They just brought pressure on with Fleischman so quickly. That's going to be deflected away again. Ovi, finally out, and I'd rather take the offside at this point. We just have no control over the puck and over our game. Where is our game? We gotta settle our feet into this one. Taking forever to find our game. Second period, Panthers find a zone entry that actually leads to a pretty decent chance from outside, as Holtby had a tough time with it. We're just having a tough time getting the puck past the forecheck of the Florida Panthers. Wolski trying to buy time for teammates. He's waiting. Just waiting forever to get a teammate involved in the play. And I think that was turned aside. Did we take a penalty? I think we've avoided a penalty for the time being. As we finally get a shot on, in God knows how long, on Jose Theodore. We're going to have to go behind the net. Schultz is interrupted. Oh, my God. Ugh! This is really the most irritating we played this season. I can't even begin to describe you how in our face. We are just congested in our own zone. We didn't even play this bad last night when I played. We need someone to just light a spark for this team. Mike Ribeiro it is to Brower. On, turned on, and aside by Theodore. We finally get something going. But again, it's a one-and-done possession. Puck finds its way back into the Capital zone. We are just going to fling it out because we're just hoping to get this thing back out over the blue line and breathe for 5 seconds, which we are doing. We are 7 minutes gone in this second period of play already. Second period of play, 7 minutes gone. And we don't have a whole lot of anything to show for it. Just take a whistle. Just get a fresh group of bodies on the ice. Holtby has got to be freaking pissed off with what he's seeing in front of him. We're not doing enough. We're not helping our goaltender out. We're not breaking the puck out. I mean, there's going to need to be a change in strategy at some point. This is not acceptable from this team. This is not acceptable from this Washington Capitals team. E-Rat to the outside. Again, just not a whole lot of space. Nothing on the half wall. Not a whole lot at the point. Come back up and support that play, E-Rat. You want to be an option. Help the team out. That's flown wide by E-Rat, so not even on that. Good pinch by Hillen, though. Like to see that action. Hillen trying to help out Ovechkin there at the point on the pinch. He's been beaten by the man. Backstrom's going to have to hustle on the back check. He does. Runs in his man into the boards. Weiss, though, in all of that, he absorbed the contact, has held onto the puck. We finally get it out. And it's going to be a Marty Erat opportunity to deke and turn it over to Kulikov. Just a great play there. Well, I mean, he was the only man in the zone. I don't really know what other option I had on that play. We were beaten by the man. Poorly defended. Flung wide again, though, by the Panthers. Erat standing by the boards. We don't even get it to him. Had a chance to make a clean breakout. I'm going. Oh, there we go. Chimera. That's got to be on net. It's in. That's what we need. A goal from Chimera. That was just a put it on net type of play. And hey, I can't complain. The puck finds a way into the back of the net. I don't care if it's just a dinky slap shot after just keeping it in the zone. It finds a way in. That's a weak one because that's short side from Theodore. That shouldn't be going in the net from any NHL goaltender. I don't care. Starting goaltender, backup goaltender. You shouldn't be letting something like that in. But I'm glad he did. And here's what we're doing. All right, we're going to go 1-2-2. 1-2-2 with all lines. Change your forecheck. And maybe we need to just change the defensive posture right now. This is not the way we need to be playing, defending zone entries or be playing in the defensive zone in general. Good play by Johansson, and he missed it again, but he blocked the shot. Pretty good shift there. God. Oh, my God. Our passing is anemic. Anemic pass. I'm going to go hard out the neutral zone. Perreault dropped to Beagle. Beagle has a dance around his teammate. Perreault on the back door. He fans on it, but that's fine. Getting it across. Carlson teed up. Rebound. Carlson gets his own rebound. Johansson. This is finally, this is it. This is the Washington Capitals that we saw in the first two games in the season. So starting to run out. Maybe we've run out of a little bit of luck here. Three games in. Oh, that's you, Perreault. No. Oh. God, Johansson, you know, he was skating in the right direction. He was skating in the general area. We have basically left the Florida Panthers to make all their decisions are just shoot the puck on the net from far outside, from long range. Now we got their D a little bit crossed up on that one. Johansson, not crossed up on the deke. It's going to be left there. Wolski trying to pass it, just making an unselfish play, but it was caught up in the skates of the defending Panthers player, Skilly. Defend this well, defend this well. Don't get beat to the inside. That's it. Green, good stick. Kopetsky still got a shot on now. And after all of that, Johansson up to Ward. We want to make the play to Ward, and he's been bumped. We don't have any. We're going on line changes. Trying to make a zone entry, we're going on line change. Like throws it high off of Theodore. We're going to go back to the point. It's going to evade way off the mark from Carl Alsner here. Or this is Green. I'm sorry, wrong player. I thought it was 27. There's Alsner. And this is Like, and we don't want to take a high-sticking penalty. We haven't seen a penalty in this game. That's the biggest shock to me. Ooh, don't let them stretch the ice like that. This is Alsner that I'm in control of here. And it'll get through off the post, though. Alsner, turnaround, stop spinning the wrong way. We're going to just dump this thing up off the glass. And that misses Ward. Joel Ward was 2 feet away. You can't make a 2 feet pass. And the Panthers dump it in again. They just keep going right at us. They know, hey, Washington's having a tough time defending us on the in the D zone and on the zone entry. There we go. I'm sorry. I'm going to look you off. And that's not a bad idea to take a shot there. Theodore was just better with the save. I had to take it. It's Ovechkin. Come on. Ovechkin on the left wing, taking a slap shot off the rush. Maybe he shouldn't have taken it from the hashies. Good save by Theodore. I mean, that's straight up. That is almost nightmare fuel for a goaltender. 2-on-1, Ovechkin teeing one up, a slap shot from the hash marks. Don't want to even think about the potential of having to face a shot like that, and Theodore's also got that one. Taking a lot of slap shots on Theodore. That's not necessarily by design. It's just how it's working out right now. This has been a game where I feel like I'm going to lose my voice. I have just been incessant commentary from the very beginning of the game, and then we've taken a penalty. AI player taking a penalty somewhere on this play. Who knows who or where it was taken or what the penalty's for. Carlson touches, almost didn't touch the puck. Interference to Troy Brower. I don't know where it happened off the faceoff, I think. It's probably some dinky contact. It is. It's kind of dinky contact, but whatever. Referee has deemed it interference. So we take the first penalty. This is shocking. We take the first penalty of the night. Taking this long to get one. The 1-for-4 Florida Panthers. 1-for-4 on the power play this season. We know we've got a good PK. So I don't want to put our penalty kill to the absolute test. Test the limits. Johansson way too far up on the forecheck here on this penalty kill. Freshly involved in the lineup in this game. Versteega, weird backhand floater. Green, that should be just floated back to center. That works. Good, simple, clear. Ovechkin stopped short of his man. At center ice, the change going on behind the scenes there for the Capitals. That is an odd angle shot, but it creates a big rebound. Nope. Cover in front. Gills! Holpe's got to have a save on that, and he does, and a game gave me a pretty quick whistle. So we'll take a D-zone faceoff. Don't want to change who's on the ice. We need a faceoff win here, Brooks, like a minute to go in the period, and a minute to go on the power play as well. So get out of the period, kill the penalty off. So if we can just kill this off, we'll have gotten out of the period. Good play by Like, and even the board pin will help kill more time. So this is all about killing time. Let's get back on the defensive side of the puck properly. And shade over there and prevent. There you go. Prevent that zone entry. Not so easy this time, huh? Stay on this blue line. Panthers on the power play are forced to dump the puck in. Which, oh! The net comes off. There you go, Schultz. Is that intentional? Holpe's continuing to push the net, even after it came off. But that will, oh, it'll be a neutral zone faceoff as well. We caught a break with that. So if we can take our time, if we can win it, which we didn't do, but we forced them to dump it in again. We got to get a quick retrieval. This has got to be up and right down the ice. That'll be the end of the period right there. No point in really chasing this down too aggressively. There you go. Just send a message. We are here to play hard-nosed hockey. Definitely one of the three games, this is the third game of the year, the most low event game offensively speaking for our team. I mean, we're a team that don't shoot the puck a lot. That could definitely be checking from behind on Backstrom. Or Backstrom? Is it Backstrom? I don't know. We've got our guy out of the box. It's Troy Brouwer out of the box. That's going to be thrown on from Versteeg from, again, long range. Nothing changing there for the Florida Panthers. Ovechkin. Oh, actually pulled off that deke briefly. He poked behind the net. Campbell. He's disturbed a little bit by the forecheck. Erap, get in there. I just wish our forecheck was having a little more success. Beautiful hit by Green. Erap tried to move the puck. And we're just going to do a nice saucer pass. It will find Wolski, who's bumped into by Jovanovski, who defended it well. Panthers are defending really, really, honestly, they're defending really well in this game. We're going to pick that back up. Wolski to Brouwer. Brouwer to Ribeiro. Turning it on. Rebound. Brouwer's second chance is also saved by Theodore. Most pressure we put on Jose Theodore. Do we think we can walk it from the... Okay. Brouwer. Oh, fed on after the up and over deke from Ribeiro. That one's also thrown on. Ribeiro, side of the net. It was a chance that he could have had. The Panthers have it back out the center. That is not stopping Brouwer and Ribeiro from trying to work him in the neutral zone, create a turnover. We got the puck, and we can saucer it to a wide-open Joel Ward. This time, Joel Ward in on a breakaway, and he tries a backhander. That does not go in. Wow. Chimera, he moved Theodore out of the goal crease physically after that save. And is this Brouwer's chance on the rebound? Yes, was it a pass? I don't even remember how Brouwer got the puck. Was that on the up-and-over deke? I don't know. There were about a good four or five looks on the net in that whole sequence. Johansson is taking the faceoff, so I know this is the fourth line without even needing to look. I know this is the fourth line. We've got Perreault and Johansson freshly inserted here in the lineup and doing a pretty good job with their ice time that they're getting. That's a... Oh, what a play by Jay Beagle. That is the defensive play of the game. And that'll be dumped in from center ice on net and a dangerously played as well by Theodore. Uh-oh. Yeah. They just continue taking shots just inside the blue line. I don't know what the strategy is there. We'll dump that in. Oh! The dump in by Johansson almost goes in. Why not? Hey, see if the goaltender's paying full attention. Do a fluky dump in play and see if you get an odd goal and Matthias is offside. Are we going to get a replay of that? No, we'll get a replay of something from Braden Holtby. Really? A replay of that? The shot just inside the blue line? This is what they've done all night. They don't get any easier for a goaltender like Braden Holtby. When you're just stepping inside the blue line and taking a slap shot, he has as much time as he wants to be able to react to it. He doesn't even have to read the shot off the stick blade. He's just sitting there ready for it. We're going to try to pass it to Backstrom, and he took a route that was as far away from the puck as he possibly could. Great logic from Backstrom there. Do a full circle around the puck there, even though the pass was missed. Ovechkin shouldn't be missing passes like that. Ovechkin is too good of a player. Another one from outside. So now, are they testing Holtby now? We're going to try something behind Erat. And then we do a circle around the puck again. Man, we just cannot find the puck. Find a teammate with a pass. Defending the blue line very stout now. It almost looks like we're a 1-4 stacked wall on the blue line. Bank pass to Erat. Nice and perfect. I would have driven the net more I would have driven differently to the net with Ovechkin there. We could have easily had the puck to Ovechkin. And instead, the Panthers are back the other way with it. Versteeg, oh my God, this guy is going to end up in bandages by the end of the game. But a snipe by Versteeg. And that was a little bit of a right back at you. He takes the physical punishment but scores the goal that has tied the game. Knocked it down out of the air. Brilliant play by Chris Versteeg, honestly, to knock that cleanly out of the air in a legal fashion, not above shoulder height, and then go bar down. That's just what we get for playing around with it. Again, we have caused Braden Holtby with a shutout halfway through the third period of play, and we got a tie game in regulation. So now we got to start earning it. I don't know if we need to just simply go back to dump and chase. We've been able to find ourselves in a few either breakaway or odd man rush situations in this game. That's an awkward bank pass, but it is just a self pass, basically. Ribeiro with a chip in play. Oh, Brouwer ran out of room. Just ran out of room. You know, I say this, but man, Ribeiro is going to be a very important tool for this team offensively this season. I mean, he is a bit of a tool, if you know what I'm getting at. But he's going to be an important tool for the offense this year. We got to utilize him and any line that he's on. That was almost a goal. That was just beautifully played. He took the whole lower part of the net away with the pads. Tough to walk out in front of a goalie like Jose Theodore and just slide it through the pads there, five hole. But Hillen, I'm going to just play it, saucer pass to the corner. Joel Ward knows exactly what to do, where to go. Get that Hillen. No! Oh, we should have been on the puck. That's a hip check opportunity we didn't get. Right back out. This time, Versteeg is not going to knock it down, and Brooks like a little dangle. Flipped in. Not intended to be flipped in. I was trying to do a windmill deke, and it just ended up being flipped in. Hillen a little behind it. He's tripped up Jack Skilly. And we got to get, yeah, we got to do a better job defensively. Can't be taking dumb penalties like this. We just got bailed out by Holpe with a good save. And we got to go to our we are going to our second penalty kill. Where are our power plays in this game? I mean, I jacked up the penalties in this game for this season mode, and we're not getting any in this game right now. We need to see Ovi. We need to see Ribeiro on the power play. We're going to need to get a power play if we want to either... Hopefully, we don't give up a goal here killing this penalty. But if we do, we're going to need a power play to tie it. We need a power play probably to just win the game. I mean, based on how potent our offense has been in the first couple of games this season, you would have thought that we would have an even strength, more than one even strength goal so far in this game, but we don't. That's a lazy clear out, but hey, man, that worked out. And I'm trying to saucer this. Backstrom, let's just take it shorthanded. Make him work for it. Here we go. Backstrom, nice try. There you go. Like is involved in it too. That was a neat little dangle. We almost perfected that play with Backstrom. And I'll tell you what, Chris Versteeg, now he's throwing the punishment. He has been all over the play tonight in multiple facets. He's been physically involved, both delivering the hits, and he's been on the receiving end. But he's also been creating the offense. He has the only Florida Panthers goal of the game. He's been trying to get involved a lot more offensively. In this one, we throw it through the crease again, just trying to get it back on net. And that's the risk of missing the net like that. But the Panthers dump it in. Green, he knocks this one out of the air, and that's going to go cleared right back over the red line, back into the Panthers' D zone. Good pressure by Johansson, but maybe a little too much. And they are offside again. Man, you guys are struggling to carry the puck over the blue line. And what did Johansson do? Oh, nice try. I don't think this got on net, but he tipped it. And that was just a simple, that was before we threw it through the crease on the other side, where it missed the net. He's trying to get something on net while killing a penalty, and we do clear this one the full length of the ice. We want to kill this penalty off. We have to. This is not a... We want to. We simultaneously want to kill this, but we also have to kill the penalty. Alsner, tie him up. There you go. Hit him along the boards. Gets a stick on it. Got to block it. Holpe will catch it anyway. And Alsner is going at someone standing in front of the net. I think it's Weiss. He doesn't like what Weiss is doing, and he's sending a message. Look at this. Look at him going at it. Tempers are flaring here in the nation's capital tonight. Alsner, right after this. Yeah, Weiss was trying to go after Holpe. That's why he was pushing Weiss around. And now our number 9, Ribeiro, needs to win the faceoff. He does to Holpe. Don't know if I would have tried to do that. That was a... Would have caught many goaltenders off guard. Windmill deep by Wolski. To Ribeiro. Rebound. Finds the pad of Theodore. But we just couldn't get on the second chance opportunity that we needed. Upshaw. In on Holpe. D to D. There we go. Good play. Good play. Good play. On the boards. Ribeiro is skating as slow as possible. Give that guy some cocaine. A line of cocaine. And he might find the energy he needs for this third period. We need a power play, man. Florida, you got to take a penalty at some point in this game. Wolski. Dumps it in. Not a bad play. We didn't really have a whole lot of anywhere to go with that. Don't take a tripping penalty here. 3.5 to go. Facing our potential first overtime game of the season. We haven't been to overtime yet. That's a risky pass for Backstrom, and that's why I had to try and do a deke, but I was a little tardy with it. Up to Backstrom. And again, we just kind of floated in on Theodore. Oh, right there. Ovi, shoot! And he missed it. Oh, Ovechkin in the slot. Misses the puck. We got it back. Kick it down low. E-Rat in front to Backstrom. Save on the short side by Theodore. This is good pressure. We need to do this. We need a power play. Nick Backstrom, the leading scorer for the team. Does he have a point tonight? Because I don't even know who scored the goal tonight. I can't even remember who scored the goal tonight that we have. Across green. I'm trying to be patient with the puck. I don't just want to take a shot. We don't have to. Ovi. Down low to Backstrom. Good connection. Oh, no. Backstrom got sent down before I could even make a pass. E-Rat, we got to be on that. That's a good rhyme. Dump in? No dump in here for the Panthers. There it is. Someone get on these boards. We're changing behind the play, so I'm going to throw it. And again, Joel Ward is just way too far up to even be able to retrieve the puck there. He does have it now. Couldn't find like. That's got to be dumped in. Got to get 200 feet down the ice. Chimera. Oh, Chimera has the goal, doesn't he? That's right. We have that slap shot goal. Alster. Oh, we're onside. Oh, I didn't want to take a shot right there, but that's fine. I was surprised he even got through all that. Fleischman from a range. Don't let this be the game here. Holpe turned aside off the blocker. Alsner, we gotta get it out. We will. We might ice this. Erat's got to find his skating legs here if he wants the gate. Icing, but they touch it. And it is touch icing. 14.2. We can't change lines. We could take a timeout. But I'd rather reserve that timeout for if we need it in overtime. That was never going to hit the net either. That save that Holpe made. But hey, it counts on the stat sheet as a save. Need this face-off win. Brooks Light does win it. And that dangerous pass going up the middle. Normally you wouldn't go up the middle. I'm looking for a teammate. Chimera. Sir E-Rat. Oh. And Kuba played it really well. We just got to shoot it. And we do. We put everything we could on Theodore in this game, including just before the horn. And he has just been better. Enough to force overtime. Our first game going to OT. This is the goal that did it. The play by Versteeg to knock it down on the clearing attempt. Well, boys, we've done everything right except win this game so far. But now we're playing 4-on-4 overtime. I'm going to let the beast be unleashed here. Alex Ovechkin, you have full reign to do whatever you want, especially if we get a power play in overtime, which this has been a penalty-free game for the Florida Panthers, which is a shock to me. That this has been a penalty-free game for Florida. Ovechkin, you gotta go. Beast unleashed, right? Here we go. Wind it up. Wind it up, son. Let's go. Oh, that is not what I expect from Ovi. Now he's gonna be pissed off. He's got no helmet. He got knocked down on the play. We tried to do a deke. Carlson kept for Ovechkin. He let it go. Ovi is rattled. He can't. Oh my God. Ovi is rattled. He can't play with the puck. He can't play. All right, there we go. Back to the defenseman, and misses Carlson. We'll go across behind the net, up to Ribeiro. Ovi changing. I was going to pass to Ovi, but he's changing. Ribeiro can't do a deke. Oh, no. Ribeiro missed deke. Get a stick on it. Get in there. Green. Carlson. Now we have Ribeiro again. Ribeiro on the zone entry. We're going to wrap it. Well, we'll float it. That was supposed to be behind the net, but that's okay. We're a little out of sorts to start overtime at some point. There's Ovechkin's helmet sitting in the corner. All right. We need a face. If we get the face-off win, I'm going to walk the middle. Oh, my God. That pressure came on real fast. Wasn't expecting Bergenheim to get there so quickly. That's got to be on that Wolski. You're going to be on this overtime group. You'll be on the puck. Wolski. With Backstrom. Wolski walks around. He dances. Backstrom off the side of Theodore or the side of the net. It rolled out behind on the other side. Backstrom is back checking like a mother. And there you go. There you go. D-D-D. Oh, I'm going to float this. Versteeg here to knock that one down. What are we doing here, Florida? What are we doing? Dumping it in. I'm sure they don't like to dump it in overtime, but they have to. We wrap it. Ovechkin is there. He's got the puck now. He's going to wind it up again in overtime. Second time winding it up. And he's still got the puck. Stick lifted. Ran it right into Theodore. Trying to probably perhaps do too much with Ovechkin. There will be a timeout taken if we get a next whistle. I got my timeout. I'm going to use it. So I am threatening to use it. I'm going to wrap that hard up for Erat. It misses Erat again. 46 seconds. Cover your man. There we go. Drop pass to Erat, forcing it, but we get it right back. It basically was a pass right back to him across Ribeiro. It floats in the Theodore. He's going to cover it, and this will be my timeout. All right. Timeout taken, and we got to make sure that the first power play group is on the ice. I say just crash the net. No, let's go overload. We're going to change it for this overtime here. I mean, it's not much of overtime left. This was the chance we just saw from Ribeiro. I think those were all saves made by Theodore. Oh, we really could have used the faceoff win there. He had Ovi in his prime spot in his office. 24 seconds to go. You're way offside, Fleischman. Should that be a D-zone faceoff? It is. All right, we got to win this, Chimera. Come on, Shimmer. There it is. Ovi, get open. Okay, screw it. I'm taking a shot. Oh, what a save by Theo. I don't... Ovi, side of the net. Ovi, 13 seconds. Dances, finds Chimera. I don't like it. Over. Ovechkin, stick lifted. Gets it back. Ovi, bounced by Huberto. Stick on it. Saved by Theodore. Oh, man, what a great into the overtime period. All the pressure. And we are going to go to the dreaded shootout. That was a chance Backstrom had that I was talking about. I moved Ribeiro. So Ovechkin was in the one hole. He's in the two hole now, shooting second for the team. Huberto over Stieg Fleischmann. We know that's the lineup for the Panthers. So we're going to see what Jonathan Huberto has for the Florida Panthers. Oh, what is this camera? Different camera here in the shootout. I guess we're going to use overhead for the shootouts now. It used to be the low camera angle. So a good save by Holpe on the first attempt. And now I get Mike Ribeiro, who's not right-handed. He's left-handed. Yep, it is going to be overhead, but that's fine with me. All right, let's see what we can do here. Mike Ribeiro, I swear that is not going to count. Oh, my God. Great handles there, Ribeiro. Clearly, he is not sober for this game. And now this is Versteeg, right? He has the goal in the game. He doesn't hear. Nice save, Holtby. So now I get Alex Ovechkin, and I got to figure out, do I do a deke? I think if I do a deke, I just do something simple initially. I don't even know what to do. I don't have any fancy dekes in my mind. I'm going to go wide with it. We can just do like a little draggy. Oh, good save. Good save by Theodore. Man, I tried to roof it. He just did a good job of taking away the angle, taking away the net with the glove. Fleischmann, always a good one to score for Florida. Will he do it in the shootout? He does. Oh, got to score now. I don't even know who's in the third hole. Was it Backstrom? I can't remember. Yeah, hopefully it is Backstrom because I'll do better with a left shot. Now, I'm going to come in. I got a plan with Backstrom, kind of. I need a goal here. Yep, it is Backstrom. Nick Backstrom, let's go, buddy. So I'm coming in, and I'm going to fake. Oh, we kept it out. And that's it. We lose in the shootout. Really unfortunate for us to drop the extra point to Florida, but it's going to be a long season, and we have yet to lose a game in regulation. I'm assuming Eric Fair will be back, and I'm going to get that notification ahead of this game against the Leafs. We might even hear on the status of Dominic Moore. Well, there you go. Eric Fair is back. And I think I'll just go in and take a look at that because I don't even know what rating Eric Fair is. Let's just see. 77 overall power forward. We're just going to keep him out of the lineup. And just, if we feel we need to put him back in, we'll inject him back in. But I'm going to leave things as is for right now. Oh, there you go. Dominic Moore has accepted our offer, so we have more center depth in case of injuries. I haven't had a D injury yet, so I have no defenseman to go sign just yet. But you see that the AIs are signing free agents left, right, and center. Paul Ranger is now off the board, and so is Paul Mara. Anybody else off the board? Nashville signing a goaltender.